first speaker, the keynote address, is by Ms. Anita Nayyar. She's the CEO India and South Asia, Havas Media. Ma'am, can I have you on stage, please?
Good morning, everyone. Thanks, Indian Television, and thanks, Anil, for giving me the opportunity to speak here. One very interesting thing about Indian Television is that, you know, you guys get onto a topic and then focus on it and then really get into micro-learning on that topic, which not too many forums do, because it's very, very important to concentrate and understand, you know, what one is talking about. The next few slides, there is honestly nothing new that I'm going to tell you guys. So at the end of the presentation, you might say, "Arey, ye to mereko pata tha," you know, but the point is that when you look at content in a context, it's always good to look at it from that perspective, and it throws a lot of interesting learnings there. So given the changing dynamics, the way digital is leapfrogging, and you know, we are trying our level best to catch up with the speed at which it is going, I think it's really the race to keep up with the changing times that one is talking about. I think we live in a world which is overloaded with content, and I mean, these numbers everybody knows, whether it is the tweets that go out, whether it's the Facebook posting that happens, and the frenzy with which the videos are being uploaded by the hour. It's absolutely crazy out there, and it's absolutely an overload of stuff that is happening. So how do one really, you know, get around it and get it into some context to talk about? I mean, digital videos, and I'm sticking to the topic of video economy here, they've grown significantly over the past 2 years. We know that, you know, the reach of digital video today is actually inching much, much closer to the reach of urban television. So the thought process and the discussion between marketers and advertisers is, oh, should I then replace television, you know, with video? Well, the fact is that the video consumption is increasing because of the man out there, Jio, which is obviously created a space for everybody where you are not really going to pay too much for the data consumption. So India being a value market, you know, anything that is cheap gets latched on. So the data prices have cut down, the consumption of data is increasing. There is a tremendous growth in terms of the internet data that is being consumed, and who and where and how is it being consumed. Now, obviously, with the data prices coming down, no rocket science there to say that, you know, there's a dramatic rise in the streaming services. So you see the streaming apps like a Gaana or a Saavn, which is growing 3 to 4 times, or even your OTT platforms, which are growing really, really very, very fast at 4 or 5 times, you know, in the past. I think a year or so, you would have figured out as to the amount of fast-paced stuff that is happening, you know, on these platforms. Also, you know, interestingly, when one looks at data and the time spent on television and digital is honestly the same. So 1.5 hours on an average time spent by an individual in a day is both on television as well as on digital. But that doesn't mean the television has become extinct, because in a country like ours, in India, television is still yet to stay. You know, being sponsored by Colors, Raj is going to kill me if I say it's not going to stay. But actually speaking, television is going to stay, because 55% of the youth is still watching television. They're watching television with their family. And interestingly, the content discovery is happening on television. I mean, there are a lot of OTT platforms where series are happening, or there are special originals that are happening, whether it's a Netflix or an Amazon, you know, or a Sony Live or wherever, and you get to know about them from television. You know, so, slightly short of saying that when, you know, Google and Facebook came to the country, they used print media to advertise, right? They still do. Google Pay still does that. So the question is that television is not really, you know, going anywhere for some time, but I think the two are working in conjunction with each other. And even more interesting is that the television screen has changed. So it's the little thing in your hand, the smartphone in your hand, which is really the new television. And the consumption that is happening on that smartphone, large amount of that is happening in the area of entertainment, followed by search, because, you know, with the online shopping, you know, increasing by leaps and bounds, and you can see the Amazons and the of the world, you know, advertising so much with those jackets on print that one issue of Times of India is actually 50 crores a day, you know, with all those jackets coming up. So the question there is that that is really the second category, which is really, really consuming a lot of digital space from consumers. I picked up these slides from yesterday's brand equity, so all credit to Bennett Coleman on this. The question is, very interesting where you were talking about, Anil, that, you know, you go back smaller towns and you go back to different audiences. Interestingly, older audiences are the ones who are spending a lot of time watching online video. You know, so the study shows that in the age bracket of 44 to 45, almost similar amount of consumption as between 15 to 19. And we would, you know, assume that our kids at home are the ones who are the only ones who are consuming video. Not really true, because the older ones are actually consuming online videos. Also, small towns, again, you know, the consumption of videos, the amount of time that the small towns are spending on video is crazy, because 1 to 5 lakh plus towns, 1.4 hours every day, vis-a-vis the top 8 metros, which is 1.25. You know, the difference is only 20 minutes. But the question is, look at where the metros are and look at where the, 5 lakh plus or 1 to 5 lakh plus towns are. So a lot of consumption of these online videos happening in small towns, not surprising, because today with the metros becoming saturated, I think the advertisers are and the marketers are looking at growth coming from, tier two, tier three towns as well. And this is where, you know, you can use those platforms. Also, if you look at genres, well, while we would think that news and news-based programs or Hindi movies, etc., as a genre works very well in on television in terms of consumption, but it's a little different on the screen, on digital, because comedy and user-generated content, movies, music videos are the ones which are the most watched there. Also, maximum spends are really going behind video. So, you know, it makes video then even more important as a format for advertisers to try and see as to what is going into that video, is that making any difference or not. So the maximum amount of digital spends are going behind video, and, you know, the preferred language, given the way our country is panned out with, you know, almost 60% out there in the semi-urban and the rural areas, where Hindi is becoming a very, very important language in terms of consumption. And that throws out a lot of scope for regional content or regional videos that should be coming up. E-commerce, FMCGs, telecom, really these are the ones followed by BFSI sector, which are really the ones which are the most advertised categories who are using digital as platforms within digital video, as a platform in terms of advertising. Now at Havas, we have a proprietary study internal to us, which is called Connect. Basically what it does is it actually looks at the role of various touch points in a consumer decision-making journey. So whether it is awareness, discovery, preference, purchase, or share, in the consumer's decision-making journey, what this study internally for us also throws out is that videos are becoming extremely important even in terms of building awareness, and also in categories like FMCGs. I mean, you would think that, you know, why would a video lend itself, you know, to specifically to building awareness? So this study actually gives us a lot of touch points, and the touch points are very, very different across the various stages of the consumer decision making journey. So interestingly, again, video is something that is repeatedly coming back to you and staring in your face there. So having said that, just a quick recap of, you know, since there is a drop in data price, obviously this data consumption is going up, and which is obviously giving rise to streaming services. Time spent on television is equal to time spent on digital. Smartphone is your new TV. Hindi, obviously, on smartphones is what is preferred. Older age groups and small towns, surprisingly, are heavy viewers of OLVs. And video is taking maximum spends. So OLVs are helping in awareness. And all this really is, what is it driven by? So you're talking about video, yes, video going out there, but what does video have? It's all to do with content. You know, it's all to do with content. It's all to do with the content actually getting into a context so that, you know, it entices the consumer or whatever is the objective that it serves. Now, a meaningful brand study, again, proprietary to us, that we do globally. We are the only agency that does this study to figure out as to how can we make brands more meaningful. And it clearly says that video content plays a huge role if used by brands in terms of making the brands more meaningful to the consumers. Interestingly, 39% of the content that goes out from brands in the form of videos or in any other form actually is meaningless. You know, it's very interesting because you keep on seeing videos and you say, oh, you know, I advertised, so my competition advertised, and because those two advertised, the third one advertised, without even understanding what is the context of that content to the consumer. So 40% of the content that is going out there is really meaningless to the consumers. Also, very interesting thing, that how do you, assess what kind of content is working? There are three ways of assessing it. Association as to, you know, is the content, how is the content associated with my brand? How is the content going to perform for my brand? And also, how is it going to, whether it's going to meet the expectation of the consumers or not? So as a consumer, do I expect X amount of content coming, you know, from a Kellogg's or coming from a Lufthansa or coming from Parle or wherever? So these are three very, very important pointers which tell you what is the kind of content that really works. And we've actually been able to segment content into six buckets. So there's content which is inspiring, there's content which is entertaining, content which educates, which informs, helps, and rewards. So clearly, the study has been able to bucket the content in terms of these six segments. And then we actually map it with the categories to say which is the category where, for example, education matters a lot. Or that kind of content, if shelled out in the market, is making sense to the consumers. So Indian consumers, actually, in the context, you know, what is the kind of content they want from brands? So they want brands to give them experiences, find solutions for them, give entertaining content. I mean, entertaining content, whether it is connected with the brand or not connected with the brand, is consumed. Yeah, but if it is making sense along with the brand, then at least it is making far more sense. We are in the era of storytelling, so I think brands are already getting into this whole thing about weaving stories around, you know, what their deliveries or what their benefits to the consumers are. And of course, you know, are we creating enough events in terms of content? So basically, if you look at content effectiveness, we've gone through a lot of categories, you know, in the industry to see which category wherein the content is important. So in Indian context, travel or aviation, you know, it also takes into account the Ubers and the Olas, so by which means it is transport, travel, stroke, aviation, where actually the kind of content this category is churning out seems to be the most effective content as far as the consumers are concerned. And retail seems to be churning out the poorest of content. You know, so the consumers just do not connect with the kind of content retail is churning out. And the other thing is very important, while it is taking shape now, is the whole area of wellness and health, where actually consumers want the brands to create more inspirational and entertaining content for them. When we talk about the video content, these industries are using various formats. So there are documentary formats, there are long movie formats, or music videos, or short movies or videos, or web series, even those kinds. So there are various industries or various categories which are using one or two of these formats, or all of these formats as well. Now, if we look at, you know, the documentary kind of a format, in India, and I'm looking at only just sharing with you the transport and the food categories here. We've got about 35 categories, where you can get to know as to what content matters to which category. But in the case of transport and food, you know, the documentary content is used by, you know, the likes of Lufthansa, Vistara, Air India, and also in food by Amul and Boost and Kellogg's. And I have a couple of examples to show you. So I'll just quickly go through this. So there's documentary content, there's long movie content, which the brands are again using. And you will see, you know, Lufthansa, Vistara, Emirates are repeatedly coming there because they seem to have cracked the code for the video content that works. Also, music video content, again, similar brands coming up, or your short movies or video content, again, similar brands coming up, and the web series content as well. You know, so these are some of the brands which are using all or some forms of content to go to the consumers. So in the case of transport or travel, you know, short movie videos and music videos are the ones which are largely used. And similarly, in the case of food, there is, the short movie, the music videos, and the web series. But if you look at the percentages that make sense to consumers, obviously the content that is being churned out in the, you know, the transport or the travel industry is making far more sense to the consumers, even when compared to food. So some examples of, you know, meaningful association of content there, Lufthansa had associated with a web series, and Emirates had associated with making a documentary. So basically what Lufthansa did was did a web series around, Runway to Success, where they got in touch with the SMEs and gave them opportunities. And actually, Satvico, is today a decent brand and doing pretty well. We used them last year for some gifting purposes because it's in the area of, health, food, and stuff like that. Similarly, in the case of Emirates, so interesting stuff. On one side, they're using a web series in the case of Lufthansa, and this is a kind of a documentary, from Emirates, obviously considering the situation and the marketplace that, that those countries are working in. So the next one are again two examples. One is in the area of short movies, which was done by Amul. I think most of you would have probably seen this. And also a web series, which was done by Kellogg's. But again, very, very interesting way of doing a web series where the brand is kind of absolutely embedded and making a difference to the lives of the consumers as well. Both of them in food, one's to do with cheese, which is absolutely non-healthy, one's to do with Kellogg's, which is absolutely healthy. But look at the treatment, look at the way they've approached the whole thing. So one is a documentary format, one is a series format. So interesting use of content where it is, I think most important thing is that it is making sense to the consumer. So the next two videos that I'm going to run, which we think are very, very meaningful from coming from brands, for consumers, and I think so very interesting stuff. I think it completely changed the stiff-lipped image of Heathrow as an airport. And this is one of the most viewed videos on YouTube as well, because it is something that's in terms of a very, very meaningful context and content, to the consumers there. The next one is the one from Emirates. So an interesting music video to really promote tourism in Dubai. Absolute context setting from the way one is really sharing the content from the consumer. So just an ending slide on whatever I had to say is that, there've never been better times to create videos. This is a day and age where video consumption is increasing, the spends are increasing, people are really, really looking at some entertaining stuff. And we all know that we have very, very complex and complicated audiences out there, so to reach them through video, which is one of the very, very interesting platforms, I think you have to find the right context and give the user that experience, which is important. Interestingly, we used to keep saying in some years back to say consumer is king, consumer is king. While consumer still remains king, today content is king in the, aspect of the consumers, because consumers are looking at content, consuming content, and if as a brand you are actually getting into the video or the content and making sense to the consumers not going anywhere. Thank you so much.